Welcome back, Macarinos, Dungeon Meisters, Hacketeers. Welcome to Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. I'm Duke of the Bump, and we are on level 17, also known as the next to the last level, also known as the penultimate level to fans of fancy words. Well, golly, it looks like I found a secret. Oh, hey. That's right, I fought one of these at the end of the last video. What are these again? Specters, I think? Sounds ghosty. Which means these might have some sort of level drain attack. I'm not sure since I haven't been hit by one yet. Wow, they seem really hard to hit. That was odd. Those are specters, right? Yes, specters. It says I fought four of them, but I think I've proved that this tally can't be trusted. I think I'm talking into the side of my microphone. Hold on a second. Okay, sorry about that. Hopefully that's a little bit better. Not really sure what else to expect besides the specters. If it's anything like the last level, then the specters will be the only enemy I have to deal with. Because the last level seems like it was nothing but those minotaurs. I don't know what the deal with that was. Or was that the level before last? Let me tell you. An empty niche. Duke of the Bones. Oh, that's just one of my busts wearing off. That's not an effect that they had. My arms feel like dead weights. Great. Oh, hey. Is that just the Kimura again? Pretty sure it was. I don't think it's like a different kind of Kimura or anything. No. It doesn't look like it. Well, dang. I was kind of hoping for something a little bit more exciting. But, I'll take it. Soundtrack is Eternal Sonata. Thanks to McGack for the recommendation. I played Eternal Sonata briefly, quite a while ago. And I enjoyed a lot of things about it, but for whatever reason, I couldn't really get into it. It was a neat game. Protection from gas. Jeez, insert joke here. I'm not even gonna stoop to that level. I'll talk about stooping to that level, but I won't actually stoop there. I could probably go ahead and re-up all of my buffs real quick. I should still have most of them. Let's see. Should probably hang on to that neutralize. I guess that's good enough. Well, no, I wanted to cast True Seeing. Is it really worth resting for? I don't know. If I start running out of places to go and I need to start really buckling down and looking for secret passages, then I'll rest and cast True Seeing again. Otherwise, I'm not going to worry too much about it. But yeah, like I was saying, I will keep True Seeing on just in case those Kimuras have some sort of poison attack. Because I'm pretty sure that in the Medusa level, the reason I got poisoned was because Medusas have a petrification and a poison attack. A Medusa's gaze petrifies, and the serpents around her head poison, which is why I guess I should. F was that? Spiritual hammer expired, really? Been a while since that happened. Probably going to need to cast two of these pretty soon, yep. Sure looks that way. Well, F it. I'm going to go ahead and rest. Just just to get True Seeing back, more or less. Since I have to re-up all these spells anyway. Yeah, I'm pretty sure most snake or serpent-like enemies in this game have some sort of poison attack, and one of the Kimura's heads is a snake. I think I called it a dragon before, but it was clearly a snake. Also, I think I called one of the heads a goat head. And that obviously made no sense whatsoever. I'm not sure what it actually was, but it sure wasn't a goat. Oh, I already cast aid. Okay. The actual effects of these spells at this stage of the game are probably negligible, but what the hell. So yeah, I'm gonna have to take a good look at that Kimura the next time I come across one, because it's a snake or a serpent, a lion, I think, and then I don't know what the other animal was. I mean, it's from mythology. It should be something I'm pretty familiar with. But I guess it's been a while since I've read any mythology. I think there are like different interpretations of the Kimura, though. Oh, here we go. Kind of like there are different interpretations of the Leviathan. Like, some people say the Leviathan is just a whale, basically. And other people say it's more like a kraken. Which a kraken could be like a giant squid. Okay. I guess it is a goat. I don't know what I thought it was. Maybe I called it like... I couldn't see the horns. Oh, I think I called it a wolf. That's right. I could cast protection from fire, but don't think it'll be that necessary. Oh, that noise must be some kind of trap. Looks like there's a trap shooting out of this wall. Yeah, it's just a fire trap. Okay. So yeah, I guess theoretically, a Kimura with a wolf head is possible, but they're going with a more traditional version of the Kimura. I guess the other head does look pretty dragon-like. I don't know. Like halfway between a serpent and a dragon, like a drake. Like a Canadian rapper. Dang. I think having the special holy symbol really is goosing my healing spells, because Cure Critical seems to be a lot more effective than usual. I meant to look up the effect of some of these named items, but it slipped my mind, unfortunately. Alright, so at least one of these teleporters I haven't been through, right? I guess it's this one, yeah, okay. Ugh, the Wraith. Yep, that's another repeat, dude. You're going a little Xerox happy with your zine there. I mean, I know you have to spread the word, but starting to lose your potential audience with all these repeats. Okay, so I guess there's nothing more I can do in this area. Unless there's a secret passage somewhere that I didn't see, and it doesn't look like it. So let's head back and figure out where to go next. Did I find a door that requires an iron key? Not sure. I don't think so. Well, must be another secret passage somewhere. Either that or something else I'm missing. Hey, I know. Let's go all the way back up. You know, I'm here at level 17. I think I proved my point. I've proved that I can hack the dungeon. Let's just go back. I mean, there's no point in just stretching this out any longer than absolutely necessary, right? I mean, come on. Do I really have to go all the way to level 18? I mean, clearly, I know what I'm doing. As you can tell by me walking around in circles. That's a new decoration, or at least one that I don't remember, but it won't let me click on it. I don't think it'll let you click on anything that's on a ceiling. Alright, well, there might be a button on the wall that I'm missing. That's the other kind of secret passage. So, I have to look around thoroughly. At least there are no monsters respawning, though. Something looks suspicious about this wall, but I guess that's just one of the textures. The wall with this crack in it. Don't seem to be very many of those, though. I guess there's enough of them that they're not really unusual. Still can't bash these down, correct? I use my special gauntlets of ogre power. Give myself a strength sufficient enough to bash down a barrier. With my mace of foos, I have a strength of 19. Come on. Work with me here. Nope. Apparently not. Apparently, there's no barrier that is smashable. Not to be confused with hip technology website smashable.com. Oh hey, there's a secret passage on my right. Okay, where did I? Oh, there we go. Thanks, perception. Brigandine. Meh. And my strength is, or my AC is only -3. I thought even without the shield, my good helmet and my good armor and my good gauntlets, it should... Oh wait, I didn't put my good gauntlets back on, did I? No, I still have the 19 strength. Put the good good bracers back on, rather. -6, there we go. That's the stuff. Hey, camera. Hammer in your haunches, man. What are you going to do about it? Going to breathe fire on me? Well, guess what? I like fire. That's actually a good thing to me. The act of having fire breathed upon me. Wait, there's a lot of illusionary walls in this level. I still don't think I've actually been hit, but the chain armor of Foos. Wow. Well, I mean, it's not better than what I have, but maybe if I use all three items, there's some effect. I should probably look that up since I'm finding all these Foos items. Of course, I don't really want to use the mace of Foos, because, screw it. I mean, I don't need to actually take those, because my strength is only 3. Trying to use a melee weapon probably wouldn't work out that well for me. But I'm not really sure if I want to use the whole set. Maybe on the next level, though, where there might not be a strength draining trap. I have one of those. Oh, wait, no. That's the wrong key. Oh, wait, no. That's the right key. Never mind. For some reason, I thought it was like a silver key, but it was a holy key. Wow, 18. That was actually a pretty good hit. They must have rolled a natural 20. As opposed to all these unnatural 20s I've been getting. Hey, a book! Well, I know it's not cursed because it's not glowing red, so I can probably go ahead and read it, right? Famous last words. It'll probably be fine. I'm pretty sure if it's not red, it's fine. Gain a point of strength, hey! Go me! I've gained a point of strength and a point of charisma. I'm moving up in the world. Although really, I don't see how my charisma can be that much higher, am I right? LOL. Yes, cause critical wounds. Exactly what I wanted to do. Well, maybe this holy symbol isn't all this cracked up to be. Maybe I just got lucky rolls. So apparently there's an exploit in this game. Or I guess it's an exploit, because if they intended this, then they did not think it through very well. But there's a magic user spell called Vampiric Touch, and you can cast it to drain hit points from your enemy, and you gain those hit points. You know, just a pretty typical vampiric kind of spell, you know, there's stuff like that in a lot of RPGs. But in this game, apparently, there's no cap as to how many hit points you can gain from that. So if you keep casting it, you can get up to thousands of hit points, potentially. Oh, hey, ooh. Ooh. That was like a living garbage bag or something. What was that? Is that a black pudding? Oh, no. Some sort of... Wow. I don't know what it is. It's a four-armed lizard creature in a garbage bag. Invisible to undead. Well, I'm pretty sure I don't need one of those. And an amulet. What does it do? It's not used in that way. Neither is that. So I have two amulets that I don't know what they do, and they're not activated by grabbing onto them. Oh, hey, I should just eat this food. Make some room that way. Well, here's the stairs. Let's hop down and get the XP, although I don't really think I need it at this point. I don't know. I think I'm done on this level. I'm kicking a lot of butt. I don't think I have much to gain by going back and filling out the rest of this map. So, level 18 of 18. This is it. Wow. You know, I honestly wasn't sure if I would ever make it this far. I was a little worried about doing an 18 level playthrough. But this is it. We made it. So, tune in tomorrow for the conclusion of Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. Unless I die. See ya.